oh my God, what is happening? There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pets.
Hey guys, Mixed Duality here, and welcome back to The Sims 4. So, as you might notice from the sim I've just created with her clothes and her hair, you might notice that I ended up getting the Cottage Living expansion pack, despite me kind of crapping all over it, I want to say, in my reactions to the two trailers that came out before the release of the pack. I actually ended up really liking this pack. I think that there's a decent amount to do, even if it's a little bit repetitive. It's pretty challenging. Like, all of my games so far in this pack have been very hectic, but it's one of those packs I found has been like really addictive. So addictive, in fact, I find myself playing it for like hours and hours and hours until I get completely burned out. So I thought it'd be fun to do some videos for my channel about it. So one thing that I've noticed as I've been playing this pack is I'm like really bad at taking care of my animals. And by that, I don't necessarily mean taking care of their needs. I mean more like bonding with the animals, which is something I really want to do because I feel like they're a big part of the pack and they're just so cute and wholesome. So what I want to do with this video is basically work around the premise that we have a group of friends who have come together to open a farm animal sanctuary for like farm animals that have come from more abusive backgrounds. And basically the whole idea is we have a bunch of, you know, vegetarian Sims who basically aren't interested in using the animals for like, you know, their wool, their milk, their eggs. They're basically just interested in befriending them and taking good care of them. And so I created this whole cast of characters that I'm actually really excited to play. So this first Sim is Clara D, and low key, she is probably like the prettiest Sim I've ever made. Like, does she not look like a Disney princess? Like, I don't even know. She just has very strong Disney princess vibes to me. Basically, her thing is she's truly a farm girl. She grew up in Hedford on Bagley. Unfortunately, her parents passed away recently, but they left her a decent amount of money and a parcel of land, which she's used to build a small farmhouse for her and all of her friends to live in and just kind of live out her farm girl sort of dreams. Clarity is very self-assured. She, of course, loves animals. All of my Sims is a vegetarian trait, so that's just what she has. Her lifetime aspiration is to be a country caretaker because that's just how she grew up. I'm actually not sure if... So basically the whole idea behind this LP is these are all actually not just like, you know, vegetarian Sims. They're actually in my mind like vegan Sims, quote unquote, which means that they aren't going to like use the animals for anything. And so basically it's just like, I don't know whether or not she can actually complete the country caretaker aspiration. If not, then I'll have to adjust her aspiration to something else. And now let's move on to her 5 roommates. So this is her roommate. Her name is Dara Chan. Not going to lie, she is very vaguely based on Jen from the Kitchen and Jorn show. I don't know if you've seen that. It's a really funny show. Dara is somebody who is just kind of a goofball. She's always had this dream of becoming a chef. So her lifetime aspiration is to be a master chef. And once she lives here, she's going to get a job at the bar in town. And so I'm hoping actually with Dara to get her into a close friendship with Sarah, who owns the bar. Next up, we have Jen Nakamura. She's originally from Mount Komorebi. She moved to the countryside in Hedford on Bagley just because she's really into fitness and the outdoors. She wanted to basically get away from all kinds of like, you know, city life, the tourist town, to kind of just pursue a more simple life in the country. So she's actually fairly highly skilled at fitness and wellness. I just picture her doing yoga outside the pond on the lot, which I'll show you in just a second. And she actually isn't just into fitness. She also majored in economics at college. Her dream, she wants to kind of go into business by selling things like jams, which they can craft at home, to the people in Hedford on Bagley to help support the farm. Next up, we have Danica Lewis. Danica is a very, very bright person. She went to university to study physics. Her whole thing is she wants to change the world to make it more environmentally friendly and better for animals by working on creating new technological innovations to greenify Sims' lives, including making a meat wall to make more eco-friendly alternatives to meat. So she's actually going to be joining the civil designer career so that way she can work towards that goal. Next up, we have Ginger Snaps. I really wanted to name a Sim Ginger, and I just thought it'd be too funny to name her Ginger Snaps. I just couldn't resist. I feel like Ginger Snaps is probably the most stereotypical vegan, vegetarian person. She's kind of like halfway between a hipster and a hippie. She's a very cheerful person. She loves animals. She came to the farm because she just wants to interact with animals and just kind of be one with nature. And last but not least, we have Kelly O'Sullivan. And honestly, I feel like Kelly O'Sullivan is kind of my self-insert character. I just relate very strongly to her. She grew up in the suburbs. She believes very strongly in environmental and vegetarian causes. And she moved out here thinking that she wanted to interact with animals more and help take care of them, but she's also kind of squeamish and she doesn't necessarily fit in with the rest of the group. Like, even though she knows them, she doesn't quite feel connected with the rest of the people who live in this house. And so she's questioning why she's even out here. She also went to college and majored in writing. Kind of her passions more center around creative hobbies like writing and acting. And so basically she doesn't quite know what she's going after in life. And she's having a little bit of a rough time in Henford on Bagley, but I'm really hoping that the rest of the people in the house will help bring her out of her shell. Although things could also not work out and she could end up moving away. I guess we don't know for sure. And yeah, that is the whole cast of characters. I love all of them. I think they're all so great. They are amazing and I am really excited to play with them. So let's go ahead and jump into the game. All right, so basically I took a while to kind of set up the story. So they already have some of their traits. They already have some of their college degrees if they went to college. Danica, Clara, and Dara have already entered into careers, I believe, pursuing their various interests. And Ginger, Jen, and Kelly are more going to be the people who are kind of paying their dues by running the farm and gardening and that sort of thing, along with Clara. Clara kind of set up this whole thing as sort of like a business that sort of hires people. Like, they're not just friends. So these are people she recruited and have gotten close to over time. And this is their little farmhouse. As you can see, it's very, very small. Clara didn't have a lot of funds to start this place. So we have two tiny bedrooms. There's a veterinarian station here to help take care of the animals. There's two bathrooms, a little kitchen, tiny little dining room, and an empty living room just because I couldn't afford any more stuff. Out here, we have a greenhouse that again is mostly empty because I couldn't afford any more than one planter. I have a garden where I want to plant all of the gigantic crops that I'm so, so, so excited about. That's one of my favorite things about the pack, actually. It's just so satisfying making these gigantic pumpkins and lettuce. Like, I think I could grow pumpkins and lettuce all day long, and I like taking them to the fairs and showing them off. So that's definitely going to be something we do in this game. We also have this lovely pond, and we have space for several different animals. So this is going to be our chicken coop. Basically, the idea is we're going to be adopting a few chickens, adopting, quote unquote. So when we buy them, it's not actually a purchase, it's actually an adoption. We're also going to have space for a cow and for a llama. And their whole thing is, like, I know they only have like a limited range, but the idea is they could walk around this whole big green space that's sheltered in from the rolling hills while still getting a beautiful view. So that's basically the setup. I'm really excited to play these guys. So let's just go ahead and get started. All right. So I don't have very much money left. I wonder if I have enough to adopt any animals. I don't think I have enough to buy it. Yeah, I don't have enough to purchase a llama or a cow, but let's go ahead and get some chickens. I want to kind of ease into this a little bit because, again, the thing I mainly want to do with this game is really just focus on befriending these animals because I feel like I'm really bad at that and I kind of want to treat them more as pets. So let's go ahead and get a brown hen and maybe a white hen, I think. And so that'll cost us $300 to adopt them. And we have $5 left to our name. We also have a simple living lot trait, so that's going to be a little bit difficult. We're going to have to go out and start foraging to help fill out our greenhouse and everything. Oh, let's go ahead and meet them. I want all of them to befriend everybody. I think Clara will go out first. She's the one who went out to the shelter and picked them up. So let's go ahead and pet this white hen enthusiastically. And they'll need names too. So I'm going to have to go out here and name them. Name white hen. Cuckoo? No. Let's say Blanche, because, you know, she's a white hen, you know. And then I know that Dara is really excited about the animals too. So let's go ahead, have her come out and say hi to the animals. She's going to go out and hug our little brown hen over here. And we're going to name her. I feel like Coco would be a good name just because she's a brown hen. And also it's just a really cute name. Okay. So unfortunately, everything is like really gross right now. There's a thunderstorm, so like everyone's scared. Actually, it looks like Clara isn't scared anymore, probably because she grew up on a farm. So she's kind of used to this whole like Henford on Bagley stormy English countryside kind of vibe right now, since we can't really do a ton of stuff outside. I want everyone to kind of get to know each other. So let's go ahead and have all of our Sims come and talk to each other a little bit, scream incoherently. So in addition to the farm animals, I really, really, really want to adopt a dog and a cat. I actually think I'll probably have them adopt a stray because I turned on the cat and dog hangout. So we should be seeing those spawn all around. We also have the simple living lot trait as well as the wild foxes lot trait. So that way we'll see foxes going around. Basically, I just want them to befriend all kinds of animals. And also that includes like the crickets and the bees. These are all like vegans. I want them to kind of like, you know, bond with animals and kind of just embrace their inner animal lovers. I feel like that's something that Clara especially is going to be into. So I'm going to have her go out here and try to bond with her bees. She and her family have always kept bees, but now she isn't using them for honey so much. She just wants to be friends with them. But if they want to come and help out with the garden, like, they're more than welcome to. Can we afford to buy any of the farm beetles? No, we can't, unfortunately. Like, we have literally no money. Okay, what's wrong with you? Oh, you're upset because you're wet? I'm gonna have you go ahead and take a shower then. That'll maybe help you. And I think actually, since we can't really do anything in the rain, it might be a good day to have everyone go down to the pub and just kind of
of go ahead and, you know, engage with the town a little bit. So we're going to go ahead and have Clara show everybody around, have them meet some of the villagers. So are we in a group together? No, I don't think we are. Let's have Clara add everybody to a group. Oh, I guess everyone is in a group. Never mind. Okay, so we're all going to go inside, and I think I'm actually going to have Clara introduce Dara to Sarah. That's a lot of Ara era names, because this is going to be Dara's new, maybe not like boss, but like manager. Okay, let's actually have everybody go in here. So are we in a group together? I don't know what's going on. Go here together. Thank you. Come on. Come on, guys. Okay, cool. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and have Dara introduce herself to her new coworker. I really want to work on her aspiration today. So she needs to visit Finchwick, Old New Henford, and the Bramblewood. I mean, obviously, you know, she's grown up here, so she's already done all of this stuff, but I mean, the game doesn't know that, so I'm gonna have to do it for her. And I know that you are going to have to do something for work. Interview a homeowner about new utilities. Okay, so this looks like it's Sarah's husband. I think she'll probably go ahead and introduce herself to him and just try to get to know the locals, because her whole thing is she wants to change the world. So really, she really has to introduce herself to the community and engage with them, so that way she can help convince them to implement new green initiatives on their farm. Simon likes the color purple. That's cool. Simon actually does not look very happy to see us. He's probably tense also because of the rain. It looks like the rain's calmed down. No, it hasn't. It's just a really thundery day today. And I haven't played this save at all except to customize the characters and everything. So basically, unfortunately, this is just how the game loaded in. Kind of unfortunate. Who are you? Are you Nancy Landgrab? Who is this? No. It's somebody else. I don't know. Danica, why don't you go like, okay, cool. Following around, what are you doing? Oh, she's showing him an invention. Let's discuss his stressed mood, because I feel like Danica, in addition to being very smart, she's also very socially intelligent, which is why she's gotten into kind of more of like an environmentalist career. Her passion is basically just, you know, trying to save the world essentially. So she's always been a very high achiever, very type A, very socially intelligent. So right now she's just trying to get some local people to know. Oh, hey, it's okay. I forget their names. Derek and Ian, I think, right? I don't know which one is which, but I feel like Danica is going to want to get to know everybody. So let's have her go ahead, even though it's raining outside. Like, yeah, I know. I'm sorry. Hopefully he won't leave. Oh no. I don't know which one you are. I can't tell. Oh, it's because I have headline effects turned off. Hold on. Headline effects on. There we go. Now I can see who you are. Derek. You are Derek. Let's get to know Derek a little bit. Maybe enthuse about city planning to him. Gossip about the neighbors. And what are you doing over here, Clara? I think that you're probably very good friends with Sarah. Like, you know, you're about the same age. You guys kind of grew up together. And you both are very, like, close with the community. You guys both have always loved living in Henford on Bagley. You both know that you're going to live here for the rest of your lives. And so I'm actually going to have Clara try to help Sarah with some of her errands. Clara's learned that Sarah is a pub owner at the Gnome's Arms. I mean, duh. She already knew that. But that's fine. And let's have her, oh wait, we can't order any drinks because we have no money. Okay, so we're gonna try to do a quest for Sarah. A simple request. You ever have one of those days where you've got too much to do and not enough time to do it? I need some ingredients for my next meal, but I'm not sure I'll have any spare time. Will you be able to help me out? Alternatively, could do a friendly visit. I've been meaning to pay a visit to some of my friends around the village, but I'm awfully busy. Would you mind taking a stroll and seeing how everyone's doing? That's definitely a Clara thing. And I think also, like, I mean, Clara's a very helpful person in general and a friendly person, so I feel like she'd be like, oh yeah, Sarah, I could totally do, you know, everything. Okay, so it looks like Sarah wants choco berries and she wants me to offer a village package to the right sim. So I'm gonna have to wander around and just see and catch up with people. Why can't I talk to Thomas? I don't know what's going on. I really wish it wasn't raining. It's so sad. Danica, we need to like really get you involved with somebody. So let's just have you continue talking to Simon and then maybe you can interview him about his utilities. Oh no, 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 no. Did it not work? Oh, did I have an embarrassing? Oh, did it not work? I'm sorry. I didn't mean to make things awkward. You know, I'm just so enthusiastic. Oh no. Let's go ahead and talk to Thomas then. She's gonna introduce herself to another member of the community, which I think would be good because I know Thomas has a big farm. His family is very influential in town. And so if she can help greenify his farm, that's gonna be a huge carbon water savings for the environment. Oh, and she left. Oh, okay. See, look, everyone's showing up now. Clara needs to talk to the mayor. I feel like the mayor was always very involved with her life. Basically, Clara has known everybody in town for like ever, but it's been a while since she's talked to the mayor just because she has been so busy starting her own farm. She hasn't really had enough time to really engage with the community as much as she'd like to. So she offered to go ahead and give Lavina some help with her errands. So welcome to Henford on Bagley. I mean, thanks. I've been here forever, but I already know you'll love it here. But in case you need any convincing, I've arranged a little self-guided local tour. Take up these few and fun, if I say so, errands, and I'll make sure you get a small bundle of rewards at the end. Okay, cool. So let's go ahead and have her sign up for that. She has a lot of errands to do. I wonder if maybe she's the person who needs the village package. baggage. I'll have her go ahead and ask her that. Is it for you? Is it for you? It looks like probably not. These foxes can be quite sly, but once I saw a rooster take one on, beak primed, knives out, feathers flying, and give it what for, such that the fox had to admit defeat and slunk off in shame. Clara's just unlocked the beef Wellington cross stitch pattern. Looks good enough to eat. That's weird. I don't know why you'd want to cross stitch a beef Wellington, but okay. One of the best things about living in Henford-on-Bagley is the sense of community everyone here helps foster. Thanks for checking in with a few of the locals, and don't be a stranger. Okay, I think actually then we did actually accomplish that objective. Interesting. Kelly, where did you go? What are you doing? See, I feel like Kelly is very like socially awkward sometimes. Like basically she's feeling uncomfortable because this whole place is crowded. So she's trying to disengage by cooking, but she doesn't realize sometimes that what she's doing is inappropriate. What is she trying to make anyway? Bake breadsticks. Okay, so she's making some nice vegan breadsticks. That'll make enough for everybody actually. So that's pretty good. Everyone grab a serving because I'm guessing all of you are pretty hungry. And this will probably has enough to feed all of you. Kelly's a loner. Loner Sims are happiest in solitude and are wary of groups of strangers. Yeah, I know, Kelly, I'm sorry. But you know, it's important to try to, you know, face your fears a little bit and just kind of, you know, ingratiate yourself in the community because that's how this community is. Oh, it looks like Dara, you are getting flirty. Who did you flirt with? Who did you flirt with? I mean, the only people you know are Simon and Sarah. So that could be a little bit of a problem. Like, why are you feeling flirty? You're not even just randomly flirty. So who did you talk to? I don't know. I'm a little bit concerned about that. I guess we'll see. Maybe her person of interest will just come over sometime. Oh, Clara, hey, it's Kim. Let's go talk to Kim. I feel like Kim and Clara grew up together as well, and so they were also pretty close. Kim, where did you go? Okay, well, whatever. All right, I think everybody, how is everyone's hunger doing? So you're good, you're good, you're good, you're good, you're good enough, and you are as well. I still need Danica to interview somebody about utilities because I really need her to do well at her career. Also, I realized that because she has the degree, she probably advanced through the career a lot faster, but I kind of feel like even with a degree, most people still get like entry-level jobs, and so I feel like she wouldn't just jump straight to the top. I kind of don't even really want that for her. I kind of want the farm to kind of grow over time. How did we get money? Oh, it was probably from the favor. Come talk to Sarah, please. Also, guys, one of the reasons I chose to have so many Sims in this household is because, oh, what's wrong? What's wrong? What's wrong with you? Is because I feel like the animals would be taken care of better with more people, even though I might be stressed from playing with all of the Sims at once. Dara, go grab a serving of this. You do this as well. But I feel like I can already tell this is going to be a super chaotic game for me. Oh no, you don't need one. No, what are you doing? Okay, whatever, that's fine. Danica, where are you? Please talk to this person about her utilities. We need to make the world a better place, and we can't do that if you just stay in your shell. Sims always come to me for life advice. You know what I tell them? Take it slow. Sometimes you try to do life on fast forward, and your needs get out of hand. First of all, as a Simmer, I feel attacked, but also, that's just not Danica at all. Like, she doesn't know how to slow down. She is so focused on her career goals and about her passions that she just is not capable of slowing down. Like, that's not her thing. Okay, can we stop this group discussion and maybe just talk to her? Please, please. Because otherwise I feel like it's never... See, I'm stuck in a group conversation. This isn't good. You know what? I think we're just going to have to leave and maybe try to invite Sarah over or something. And, you know, I mean, I think that's fine. Like, Clara might be like, hey, girl, we need to catch up. So, and then we can maybe get Danica to talk to her. So let's just have everybody go home. Everyone is scared. Oh, it's kind of late. I wonder if I can still invite Sarah over. It's probably, like, really pushing it a little bit, especially because, you know, it's a work night. I'm guessing the pub is just closing. Okay, so Sarah did agree to come over. Great. Let's invite her inside. And then you are tired. I think everybody's basically tired. I don't remember which bed is yours. Sleep here. Oh, I already assigned them. Cool. I'm gonna have everybody but Danica go to sleep so that way I can have a not group conversation because that would be good. Let's go ahead and just get to know her a little bit. I think right now we are chatting. We're just chatting with her, getting to know her a little bit. And, you know, I mean, it's not that Danica doesn't like Sarah. I think they have a different view on values. But, you know, Danica needs her help to save the world. So that's what she's going to do. If she was like in a Hogwarts house, I think that she'd probably be like a Slytherin. She's very ambitious. She mainly cares about achieving her goals, and she's basically willing to do anything to get them done. Okay, I think that we're probably high enough social now to talk about utilities. Can I do that? Enthuse about city planning, hug, get repair tips, interview about utilities. Cool. All right, please, please, please let this work, and then you can go home. Okay, cool. All right, bye. It's like midnight. I need to go to bed. Sleep. Ooh, actually, we never fed our chickens. Let's have, I think, Jen get up because she just really wants to like get that country life feeling and just scatter some feed nearby for our babes. I really wish this rain would let up. I'd really like her to bond with the chickens a little bit, but she just can't. I don't know where the chickens are. Oh, okay, cool. Okay, so locked door for all chickens. Ginger had a nightmare where their in development video game was leaked early. Not like that would ever happen, ever. That's funny. Ginger, go to bed. Go to sleep. It's okay. It's okay. You're good. Kelly had a nightmare about being chased by an overly muscular Yamachan. The dream is over, but the images last a lifetime. Okay. I feel like Kelly is just kind of very neurotic. That's such a weird thing to dream about. Your neighborhood's eco footprint is neutral. Learn more in the eco footprint lesson. I feel like Danica wants to change that as soon as possible. All right, so it looks like you didn't quite get a full night's sleep, but it looks like you just need to use the bathroom really bad. So let's go ahead and have you do that. We can't do anything with food, I don't think, because we don't have anything in terms of vegetables. So... maybe it's part of Clara's aspiration to purchase seeds, I think, right? Or her job to purchase garden seeds. So let's go ahead and have her go over here and purchase some seeds. Let's do some starter vegetables and then let's have her open the seed packet. Oh, and we have blueberries. Cool. I didn't know that. Carrots. Cool. That'll be good for when we befriend rabbits. Let's have her go ahead and plant some of each of these. And I think one of my goals for this game is basically to have them plant one of every type of seed, just because, you know, I mean, they're vegans, right? They need a diverse diet. Let's plant, please. And maybe once Danica gets to be high enough up in the fabrication skill, she can make us some hydroponic planters so that way we won't have to water anything. Oh, Dara is playing in the pond. That's a very Dara thing to do. She's just kind of a goofball. I think that Dara is definitely somebody who just wants to have fun with life and to not worry so much about ambition, kind of like the opposite of Danica. Looks like her chickens are still asleep, but maybe they need to have their coop cleaned. It looks like their coop is still good. I guess let's just scatter. No, that'll wake up the chickens. Let's go ahead and just leave them alone. And it looks like Dara and Clara are maybe trying to get to know each other. So let's go ahead and just talk to her for a little bit. I think I'm feeling kind of goofy today. So let's have some fun. Let's do some jokes. Oh no, I feel like Clara, like, you know, she's not even really a morning person despite living on a farm for her whole life. So she just was not into Dara's attempt. They're up, they're up, they're up. Okay, so let's go ahead and have our two animal loving girls come over here and just kind of get to know the chickens. I'll have you work with, what's your name? Coco. And just try to get to know her a little bit. You, meanwhile, can get to know Blanche. Blanche Dubois. Blanche Du Chicken. And then I'm hoping that once our three workers come back and get money, we can afford to adopt a llama or a cow. Oh, this is so cute. See, it's like, I never stopped to do this. Maybe eventually we can adopt more chickens. Okay, calm down, Clara. Just talk to your friends. Bunny, 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 bunny. Okay, we have all day to talk to the chickens. We are going to talk to a bunny. Hey, bud. How's it going? I feel like this is a very Dara thing to do. Like, she has the attention span of, like, a goldfish. She just sees a bunny and is like, oh my god, Dara never really had animals growing up, and this is, like, her dream come true. Oh my god, it's so cute. Oh no, oh no, 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 it's okay, it's okay, it's okay. I'm sorry, I'm sorry, I'm sorry. I think I want to name you something. Name Wild Rabbit. Sherlock. Oh my god, that's perfect. Hey, Sherlock. Oh my god, it's so cute. Look, I'm sorry, man. I'm just, oh, this one likes pets. This one likes pets. These guys are going to be best friends. Okay, so Danica, you need to go to work. Go to work. When is your job starting? Okay, so you don't work for the rest of the day, actually, and you're going to go to work soon. Let's keep on befriending this rabbit. Hey, I heard you became friends with Sarah Scott. She is pretty cool. I mean, yeah, I'd hope you'd feel like that about your wife. How do you travel underground, rabbits? I feel like if Dara were small enough to fit into a rabbit hole, she totally would. This rabbit has very mixed feelings about us. How are we doing relationships-wise? We don't even have a relationship. How do we get a relationship with a rabbit? Oh, okay, it's just under all for some reason. This rabbit just does not like us. Yeah, sure, Clara likes fitness. That's totally cool. I mean, it makes sense. She grew up on a farm. All right, go to work. And then, Clara, you need to go ahead. She needs to help Kelly get used to caring for the plants, although it looks like not. So maybe she's going to send her out to feed the hens. So because this is a vegan farm, we're actually not going to collect the eggs. Basically, it's just like the only thing we're going to be using the animal products for is actually creating things for the animals themselves. So if there's a treat that uses eggs, then I'll use that and I'll give it to the chickens. But otherwise, we won't use eggs for anything. And same with like the wool and the... Oh, no. Oh, no, Clara, Peter Pants. Ugh, Clara, you're just... I mean, it happens, but oh, you're just kind of an awkward person, aren't you? Whoa, why do we have a dog in the house? Why is there a dog in the house? Well, I mean, one of our things is we wanted to adopt a dog, so let's go ahead and have Ginger cautiously introduce herself to McGee or Magoo. That's such a weird name. We're definitely changing that. Oh, my God. Who is this? Who is this? Oh, my God. Xena? Xena is so cute. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. What is happening? There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pets just in our house right now. Is this a sphinx? Oh my god, is this a sphinx? That is so funny. Oh my god. And a little orange cat. How am I supposed to choose just one? That orange cat is kind of freaky looking, not gonna lie. Also, I feel like Kelly needs to kind of get over herself a little bit. So I think after she's done taking... Why is everyone in the shower with her still? Like, why aren't they leaving? You're gonna have to go ahead and clean the toilet. It's just for your own good. I'm also going to have Ginger talk to the cat because I love this cat and I want it. Ginger, can you please talk to the cat? cat. Like, can you wake up the cat, please? Wake up. Wake up. Please wake up. Come on, Xena. Wake up. I'm going to bother you because I want to adopt you. Whoa, what's wrong with me? I am dizzy from illness. Oh no. Get to know. Offer friendship. Pet. This is already so chaotic. Why are there so many animals in my house? Give a treat. Oh, this one's wearing a dress. Butter. Oh my god, that is hilarious. Guys, we can only afford one cat right now. Maybe once, like, we have our lives under control, we can get more, but I can't. Can I adopt you yet? I really want to adopt you. Ginger, keep on getting to know this pet. More choices. Still can't adopt it. Is something wrong? I think this cat might be bugged out, or I'm bugged out. Jen, what's your problem? You're hungry. Can you? Oh my god, these cats, they're on the counter. This is so gross. Let's have them go ahead together with Clara and Kelly. Can we make anything? We can't. We don't have anything that we can make. Ooh, that's not good. Well, I guess to clear your mind, maybe you should go for a jog. You know, that always makes you feel better. That and yoga. I need to do this before I end this episode. Like, I absolutely need to adopt this cat. Like, that is not an option. Hug, talk to, give a treat. How well do I need to know this cat to adopt it? Come on, Ginger. Hug the cat. Hug it again. I love this cat. I want this cat so bad. Xena, can I please, please, please? Oh my god, it loves her. Why can't I adopt her? Give her another treat? Hug her again? Like, what do I have to do to adopt this cat? Kelly just became acquaintances with Butter. the dog with the dress on. That's so funny. I wonder if Kelly's a dog person. I feel like Kelly didn't grow up with, like, any pets whatsoever. I am spending so much time socializing with this cat. It loves me, but I still can't adopt it. Why can't I adopt it? Are you not a stray? Is that the problem? Oh, you're not a stray. That's the problem. You belong to somebody. Okay, well, never mind. I mean, we can still get to know you, but we need, like, a pet. Okay, well, that's kind of a bummer. Well, you spent all that time getting to know them, and we can't have them. Is there any other, like, cute cat or dog in the lot that I could get? You know what? Maybe I should focus on the animals that I have. I think right now, to round off the episode, I want to go ahead and just make sure my chickens are well fed. Cool. Dara came home from work. I don't think we have enough to buy another animal yet. Let's see if we what we get when Danica comes home. Oh, I should have had them work hard. What's wrong with me? Oh, no, 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 no. Oh, that sucks. So no one's getting a promotion today. Oh, but we have enough money. We might even have enough money to buy both animals. Okay, let's go ahead and adopt a llama. Let's get a beige llama. And we don't have quite enough to get a cow. Yeah, let's go ahead and start with a llama though, and name the beige llama. Oh, Blondie, that's so cute. That's literally perfect. And I think Kelly needs to learn how to bond with animals, so let's have her go here and socialize with Blondie a little bit. Oh, it went well. I think that she's gonna end up liking it here. But anyway, guys, I think that we're gonna have to leave this part right here. I'm having a lot of fun so far. These Sims are so cute. This game is so hectic, but I think I'm gonna have a lot of fun. Anyway, I hope you did too. If you like what you saw, please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Thanks so much for watching again, and I'll see you all again very soon. Bye.